Hi, I'm Nathan Johnson, and this is my kit. Everything that I need to make makeup magic fits in one very small bag because I'm very clever about what I carry. When it comes to foundations, I have about 80 foundations with me at any given time, but I keep them concentrated to creams. So you see here, I have 4 foundation palettes. And in them, they're all broken down into warm, cool, neutral, and some deeper tones. So I'm able to very effortlessly go in right away and blend them down into liquids if I need and meet the needs of any different skin type. Again, I have 80 shades of foundation and they all fit in a space about that big. In addition to that, I always carry my 4 most popular liquids because I tend to use them the most. They meet the needs of the vast majority of people I need to use my liquids on. Or I can mix them or add a touch of my creams to get the exact tone that I need. But before you start with that, the perfect face always, always starts with the perfect primer. You always have to set the palette first. And primers should be skin type appropriate. I know a lot of primers say great for all skin types, but I happen to disagree a little bit. The ingredients that work really, really, really well with skin that has, say, a lot of oil are very different than the ingredients that do a lot to hydrate the skin. So I like to have an assortment of primers. I have primers that sort of, you know, even out the oil production. I have primers that add hydration, and I have primers that are ideal for people who have normal skin. A selection is always key. I have an assortment of eyeshadows that will allow me to meet any needs that I may have. I have brow powders. I have lip palettes. Again, you can carry a tremendous number of lipsticks when you keep them in a palette. Also, I happen to, you know, there's shades here and there that I'm always becoming obsessed with, so I'll bring a couple of shades that I might currently be madly in love with and experimenting with and keep those around. I have a selection of glosses. I keep my brushes good and clean. One thing you might notice if you look at my brushes, you'll see that I have some up and some facing down. The reason I've left some down for you and I'm not sort of fully prepared the way that I would be before a client comes is because when I'm done with a brush, to make sure sometimes if it's the end of the day and you've got a lot to do, I always clean my brushes very well when I get home. I give them a full bath, but I also make sure and I rinse them first with my sanitation products to keep track of all of my brushes when I've used them. I turn them upside down, so I'm always able to keep them completely separate. Although when I do get home, I do a full sanitation of my entire kit. I happen to like my foundations to be from professional brands, like CoverFX is ideal, Makeup Forever makes beautiful ones, 3 Custom Color Specialists, Tarte. There are so many incredible options. What's great about them is they don't have drying agents in them. You have to set them with powder, so you're able to get the true read that you want. And some of the drying agents later, when people start to sweat or their oil comes to the surface, they can start to change tone through the day. I like to have a lot more control over my makeup. Another thing that I also think is awesome that I have to mention to you is the Skindinavia setting sprays. These go on with a beautiful, beautiful effortless mist, and they have a variety of them, some that soften and give a beautiful glow to the skin, others that control oil. It's an amazing product, and it will be a great finishing touch to make sure all the magic that you've created stays all day. Now, a couple other things that I consider specialty products that I'm just madly in love with. I have some awesome highlighters. This highlighter is my personal favorite. It's by The Balm, and it's called Mary Lou Manizer, and it just gives the most gorgeous glow. But I do recommend being careful with it, because it can almost, it's so pigmented that it can almost look, you know when people over-highlight and it looks like there's metal on the face, it just looks like, you know, the top of a tin roof? A little too much of it can be a tin roof, but just the right amount and you are perfect. It's also amazing for lid shade, highlight below the brow, and the perfect little kiss at the inner corner of the eye. Another product that I can't live without are Eve Pearl's Salmon Concealers. They are the perfect pinky peach shade, and they absolutely banish every bit of the under eye darkness like that. It's amazing. I cannot live without them. My advice to you with your kit, find things that you love. Find things that you adore. Now you'll notice there's a huge variety of products here. I've got NARS, I have 3 Custom Color Specialists, and if you don't know them, you should. They are amazing. It's all handmade makeup. I have makeup designery products. I have a lot of CoverFX. I keep my my kit very broad, but you'll find there are things that you can get from a drugstore that do things just as great as what you can get from, you know, the professional makeup artist stores. Personally, I like my foundations to be pro. I don't like drying ingredients in them. I like to set them with powders so that I get the best read and so I can control them so they won't change tone later if they absorb sweat and oil from the person who's wearing them. But things like lipstick, eyeliners, lip liners. I have fallen madly in love with some shades that you can get right at your basic drugstore. And if you're madly in love with a $7 shade, it's certainly a lot easier than paying $22, $25, or $30 for it. Play, experiment. There's no shame in using products that are less expensive, none at all. The magic, the great thing, is just finding the products that work for you. That's what's most important. I'll tell you, for example, my go-to, I have two go-tos. I happen to love Lights, Camera, Lashes by Tarte. And guess what? As far as the pro lines go, it's one of the more affordable ones. But I am never without my L'Oreal Voluminous. And that's like a couple of bucks. And it's amazing what it can do. So never be afraid to experiment. And additionally, you really want to get to know all the products that you can. Because guess what? Your client is probably not buying pro product. So make sure that you know these products so that when they ask you, how's this drugstore product, you can tell them. The more you know, the more you can tell them. That's my kit.